Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, a mathematics teacher. In today's lesson, we are in Form 2, Lesson 20, and the topic is reflection and congruence. And the subtopic is the condition that must be satisfied by congruent triangles. What are the things we supposed to look so that we can say that the two triangles or this shape and this shape is congruent to the other or it is not congruent. Lesson objective, by the end of this lesson, you should be able to state the four conditions that must be satisfied by congruent triangles. The first condition, three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of the other triangle, and therefore in this case it is represented as SSS, 3S, meaning that the three corresponding sides are equal. For example, in this case we can say that we have a triangle ABC, the side AB is equal to PQ to this as far as the second triangle is concerned, and also BC is equal to the QR, and AB is AC is equal to PR in that case. That is condition number one. In condition number two, two sides and one angle are the ones which are supposed to be equal. Two sides of one triangle are equal to two sides of the other triangle, and also one angle of one triangle is also equal to the other one. And in this case, you can see that there is a triangle ABC. And therefore, in the triangle ABC, it is an isosceles triangle whereby side AB is equal to side AC. And you can see that there is a common chord which is represented by the perpendicular bisector line A to D, where the 90 degrees is. There is point D there, and therefore we can have two triangles, that is the triangle AD. We have triangle BAD. Remember the D should be where the 90 degrees is, BAD, and also the triangle DAC. We have the triangle DAC, and therefore the two triangles, we can say that they are congruent because two sides, as far as this triangles are concerned, are supposed to be equal, and also there is an included angle there which is also supposed to be equal to one another. Then we can go to case or condition number three. In condition number three, we have the corresponding side is given, and a pair of angles is also given, and therefore you can see that there are two angles here which are given, and they are supposed to be equal to one another, and the corresponding side is also given, meaning that only one side is equal to one another. For example, in this case we have triangle EFC and the triangle RST, and therefore the side which are supposed to be equal to one another in the two triangles, we have side FC is equal to side ST, and also the angle TSR is equal to angle CFE, and also the angle FEC is also equal to angle SRT. And in this case, that is the third condition that satisfies these two triangles, and therefore we can say that the two triangles are congruent. Then we have the condition number four, and in this case you can see that we have two corresponding sides are equal, and two corresponding angles are also equal to 90. For instance, in this case you can see that triangle PQR and PRS are congruent because PR is a common line, it is a common chord into both of the triangle, that is PRQ and also PRS. They have a common chord, that is PR, and also angle PRQ is equal to angle PRS, which is supposed to be 90 degrees. And also we have a line PQ. PQ is also equal to PS, and therefore in this is the fourth condition, and we can say that triangle PRQ and PRS are two congruent triangles. We have come to the end of today's lesson, and I'm going to end this lesson by giving you assignment. State any four conditions that must be satisfied for any two triangles to be congruent. As we have already discussed them, so you are supposed to state them as I have explained them in this session. Then, for reference, you can refer from Secondary Mathematics Student Book 2, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, or if you would like to clarify something from us, you can reach us at LMTV using the following addresses. You can use SMS using the number which is well displayed for you, YouTube at LMTV, Facebook at LMTV, and also Twitter at LMTV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson, bye-bye.